Hello guys, and welcome to this video to learn a little bit about the sinus anatomy and pathology, okay? So we need to understand about the location and the extension of the sinus cavity. And as we can see in this picture, we have the buccal and lateral walls of the sinus, which are the cortical bone of the maxilla. But then we have the posterior wall of the sinus, which is in contact with the pterygoid process, right? So here in this picture, we are seeing the lateral plate of the pterygoid process and even the beginning of the medial plate of the pterygoid process, which belongs to the sphenoid bone. We have also the medial wall of the sinus, which is the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. Please note that when I say medial, I mean close to the center. When I say lateral, I mean away from the center. And the roof of the sinus, which is the floor of the orbit. Now, the sinus floor is usually in proximity with the roots of the molars and sometimes even premolars. So we need to remember that the mesial extension of the sinus can go up to lateral incisor or canine, and the distal extension of the sinus can go up to the tuberosity of the maxilla. There are several pathologies that can happen in the sinus, but most of them are related to the sinus membrane, which was known as Schneider membrane. Okay, so we can see here in this sagittal slice of a CBCT that we can see the contour of the sinus membrane, which is following the contour of the sinus floor. And the sinus floor is now being pushed by this periapical lesion, right? So it's very important to diagnose the alterations related to the sinus. And it's also very important to diagnose the anatomical variations of the sinus, such as the septum. Okay, so that's a bony septum that is crossing the maxillary sinus, and this is an anatomical variation we are not going to see in every patient, but it's one of the possible anatomical variations of the maxillary sinus and has some implication for surgeries, for example, for the sinus lift procedure. Similarly, sinus membrane thickening usually means inflammation of the sinus. Okay, so we also need to pay attention to that, as this inflammation can be happening due to a periapical lesion or a periapical alteration of one of the roots in proximity with the sinus. Finally, it's very important to see the proximity between the sinus and the upper third molar, as this tooth can be displaced into the maxillary sinus during extraction if this tooth is very close to the sinus or if the surgeon is not careful enough. So if you guys like this video, please hit the like button and see you guys on the next videos.